Agarwal is from the pituitary glands. It's the salivary glands. There are total three pairs of salivary glands. Three pairs of salivary glands. One is number one. Number one that is pituitary gland. Total three pairs of pituitary glands. Yeah, number one that is pituitary gland. Three pairs of salivary glands in the body. There are number one that is pituitary gland, number two submandibular, and number three that is sublingual. Number two is sublingual, submandibular, and number three is sublingual. Sublingual gland. So here we'll discuss about this pituitary gland. This is a pituitary gland, and it is located. It is the largest of the three pairs of the pituitary glands. Total three pairs of the salivary gland. This is the largest, which is this pituitary gland is the largest gland, and it is the largest gland and its location. At first, we'll discuss about the location of this pituitary gland of the pituitary glands, which is located. By the side of the face, it's located by the side of the face and upper part of the neck. And the upper part of the neck. This is the upper part of the nose of the each side of the from the east side and below the external carotid, external acoustic meatus. And extending from ramus of the mandible, here's the mandible, ramus of the mandible in front of the mastoid process behind. In front of the mastoid process behind. So this is the location of this of the parotid gland. So this is the pituitary gland. This is pituitary gland. This is the pituitary duct. This is pituitary. This is pituitary duct, and this is the styloid process. Here is the styloid. Here is the styloid process, and this is the pituitary gland. So the shape of this pituitary gland is it's an inverted pyramid. It's like an inverted pyramid. You can see it's like an inverted pyramid, and weight is about 25 pounds. Weight is 25 pounds, and its weight is about 25 pounds. And the now we'll discuss about the relations of the pituitary gland. So the apex, it overlaps the. So at the apex, it overlaps the posterior. At the apex, it overlaps the posterior belly of digestive and adjoining part of the carotid triangle. And also the cervical branch of the facial nerve at apex. Discuss about the at apex. The apex, it's overlaps the posterior. It overlaps the posterior belly of digestive and the adjoining part of the carotid triangle. And the adjoining part of the carotid triangle, number two, that is the cervical branch of the facial nerve and the two divisions of the retroperitoneal knee. So at this apex, this is the relation at the apex. Now the relations at the superior surface. At the superior surface, it forms the upper end of the gland. This is the upper end of the gland, which is small and related to, and the upper end of the is related to. Now the related to number one, that is cartilaginous part of the upper edge. Now the superior surface, apex. Now the superior surface. Now the superior surface. The superior surface is related to the number one, that is cartilaginous part of the external auditory meatus. Number one, cartilaginous part of the external auditory meatus. External auditory meatus. And number two, that is posterior part of the temporomandibular joint. And number two is the posterior part of the TMJ. That is the TMJ is situated posterior part of the TMJ. Number two, posterior part of TMJ. And the superficial temporal vessels, and the number sí, superficial, temporal. Superficial, temporal vessels. And the auriculotemporal nerve, and also the auriculotemporal nerve. In the, this is the relations at the superior surface. Now the relations at the and superiorly, it is the largest of all the surfaces and consists of skin, then the parotid fascia, deep parotid lymph nodes, and in anteriorly, now the anteriorly it is related to masseter muscles. Anteriorly it is related to masseter muscles. Then masseter muscle lubricated. Anteriorly it is related to masseter muscles. Then lateral surface of the temporomandibular joints. Then lateral surface of the temporomandibular joint. Then the medial pterygoid and posterior belly of medial pterygoid and the posterior border of the ramus of the mandible. So anteriorly it is related to this. Now the posteromedial surface. Posteromedial surface. So the posteromedial surface is related to number one mastoid process. Number one mastoid process. Mastoid process and number two, that is sternomastoid muscles and styloid process, sternomastoid muscles, sternoid process, and the external carotid artery. So this is the relations with the posterior medial surface. And two is number that anterior border, the anterior border is related to parotid duct and terminal branch of the facial nerve, and also the transverse facial vessel and the posterior border. Now the posterior border. And the posterior border. Posterior border is related to the superficial surface from the posterior medial surface, and it overlaps the sternomastoid muscles. It also overlaps the sternomastoid muscles. And the medial surface, and the last relations of the medial surface. That is medial surface. The medial surface is related to it separates the anteromedial surface from the posteromedial surface. Medial surface separates the anteromedial surface to the posteromedial surface, and it is related to lateral wall of pharynx, and it is related to lateral wall of the pharynx. Now the arterial supply of the parotid band. Parotid gland, the arterial supply of the parotid gland, the external carotid artery, the branches of the external carotid artery are supplying the parotid gland. The branches of the external carotid artery are posterior auricular artery, then maxillary artery, superficial temporal artery, then transverse artery. These arteries supply the parotid gland. Now the venous drainage of the parotid gland. Now the lymphatic drainage of the parotid gland. Lymphatic drainage.
drainage of the parotid gland. So the lymphatic drainage leaves from the lymphatic nodule, the venous drainage. It is the venous drainage of the venous drainage of the parotid gland. Venous drainage of the parotid gland. So the venous drainage is the veins drains into the external jugular vein. The venous drainage are number one superficial temporal vein. This is the superficial temporal vein. Superficial temporal vein. Now this is the parotid gland. Superficial temporal vein. This is the transverse facial vein. Transverse facial vein. This is the transverse facial vein. This is the maxillary vein. Maxillary vein. And this is the posterior auricular vein, external jugular vein, facial vein, and common facial vein. This is posterior auricular vein. Posterior auricular vein. This is external jugular vein. This is external jugular vein, and this is facial vein and common. This is facial vein and the common facial vein. This is facial vein and this is common facial vein. Common facial vein. This is the common facial vein. So this vein, this is the venous drainage of the parotid gland. So now the nerve supply of the facial parotid gland. Now the nerve supply of the facial vein, nerve supply, the facial vein, nerve supply of the parotid gland. The parotid gland is supplied by the nerve, the gland, upper part of the posterior ventral surface and divided into terminal branches by the facial nerves. The individual branches of the facial nerves are like temporal branch, temporal branch, neither zygomatic branch, number 3, that is upper buccal branch, number 4, that is lower buccal branch, lower buccal branch, then the mandibular and the cervical branch. Five is mandibular branch, and number 6, that is cervical branch. So these 6 branches are supply the nerve. These 6 nerves of the branch, which are the branch of facial nerve, supply the parotid gland. So now the applied anatomy of the parotid gland. Applied anatomy. Applied anatomy of the parotid gland. Number 1, parotid swelling are very painful due to the underlying nature of parotid fascia. Number 1, parotid swelling. Parotid swelling is one of the very painful due to one of is very painful due to the underlying nature of the parotid fascia. Number 2, mumps. Mumps is an infectious disease of salivary gland caused by the specific virus. It's a infectious disease of the parotid gland caused by the specific viruses. And number 3, that is parotid abscess is caused by the parotid. This is caused by the spread of infection from the mouth cavity. And during number 4, during the surgical removal of parotid gland, the facial nerve is preserved by removing the gland into 2 parts. So this is the applied anatomy of the parotid gland.